chapter 5, which is trading in derivatives. In this chapter, we will have a brief look at the trading system in NSE's future and option. In the segment, we trading kaise hoti hai, wo dekhenge. The best way to get a feel of the trading system is to actually watch a screen and observe trading. But yahan pe apan kuch details dekhte hain trading ke. The F&O trading system of NSE is known as neat F&O trading system. That is a fully automated screen-based trading system जो कि index futures options, stock futures options पे trading होता है और nationwide basis पे trading होती है इसमें. There is an online monitoring and surveillance mechanism also. It supports an order-driven market है इसमें and provides complete transparency of trading. It is similar to trading in equities in the cash markets. Software hai F&O ka has been developed to facilitate efficient and transparent trading in futures and options instrument. Keeping in view the familiarity of the trading members with the current capital market trading, modifications have been performed in the existing capital market so as to make it suitable for trading in futures and options. Now, what are the entities in the trading system? There are basically four entities in the trading system. The first is the trading member, dusra hai clearing member, third is professional clearing member, and fourth is participant, trading member. Trading members hote hain exchange ke, NSE ke members. They can trade either on their own account, khud ke account mein trade kar sakte hain, ya client ke behalf pe trade kar sakte hain. The exchange assigns unko a trading member ID assign hota hai to each trading member. Each trading member can have more than one user. Her trading member ka ek se zyada users ho sakte. The number of users allowed for each trading member is notified by exchange. Number of users, jo maximum number of users allowed in a trading member ko, that is notified by exchange from time to time. Each user of a trading member must be registered with the exchange. Her user registered hona ko होना चाहिए and it should have a unique user ID. The user की अपनी एक user ID होनी चाहिए. The unique trading member ID functions as a reference for all orders or trades of different users. Users के जितने भी trades होंगे, जो trading member ID होगी वो उनका reference की तरह act करेगी. This ID is common for all users under a trading member. It is the responsibility of the trading member to maintain adequate control. फिर आते हैं clearing member. Clearing members NSCCL के members होते हैं. NSCCL is National Securities Clearing Corporation. They carry out the risk management procedure activities and confirmation or inquiry of trades through the trading system. Then there are professional clearing members. Professional clearing member are clearing member which is not trading member. Typically banks or custodians professional clearing members की तरह act करते हैं and clearing settle for their trading. Then there are participants. Participant is a client of trading member like financial institution. These clients may trade through multiple trading members but settle through a single member. Basis of trading. The neat F&O जो है वो एक order driven market को support करता है जहाँ पे orders automatically match होते हैं. Order matching is essentially on the basis of security, its price, time and quantity. चार चीज़ों पर डिपेंड करता है. सिक्योरिटी कौन सी है, किस प्राइस पे है, क्या टाइम में आई है, मैच्योरिटी क्वांटिटी क्या है. ऑल क्वांटिटी आर इन यूनिट्स. सारी क्वांटिटी यूनिट्स में होगी और प्राइस रुपीस में होंगे. द एक्सचेंज नोटिफाइज रेगुलर लॉट साइज एंड टिक साइज फॉर ईच ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ट्रेडेड इन द सेगमेंट. एक्सचेंज टाइमली बताती रहती है कि क्या लॉट साइज लेना चाहिए या क्या टिक साइज लेना चाहिए. एनी ऑर्डर एंटर्स द ट्रेडिंग सिस्टम इट इज एन एक्टिव ऑर्डर. जो भी ऑर्डर सिस्टम में एंटर करते हैं वो एक्टिव ऑर्डर होता है. इट ट्राइज टू फाइंड अ मैच. एक मैच फाइंड करने की कोशिश करता है जो ऑफसेटिंग मैच फाइंड आउट करने की कोशिश की जाती है सिस्टम द्वारा. नहीं होता है तो दीज आर स्टैक्ड इन द ऑर्डर बुक और वो पैसिव ऑर्डर हो जाते हैं. ठीक है, और अगर मैच मिल जाता है तो अ ट्रेड इज जनरेटेड. So this is all about basis of trading. Now we go to corporate hierarchy. So F&O trading software में एक hierarchy है. There is a corporate manager at the top, then there are branch managers and then there are dealers. ठीक है, corporate manager is assigned to a user placed at the highest level in a trading system. Trading system के highest level पे corporate manager बैठता है. Such a user can perform all the functions like order or trade related activities, receiving reports from all the branches. उस corporate manager के नीचे जितनी भी branches हैं उनसे reports लेना and also all dealers of the firm. और उन branches के नीचे जितने भी dealers हैं उनसे भी report करें. Additionally, a corporate manager can define exposure limits for branch. पर branch की exposure limit set कर सकता है और define कर सकता है. ये facility सिर्फ corporate manager को मिलती है. Then there is branch manager. It is a term assigned to a user who is placed under the corporate manager. Branch manager कहाँ आता है? Corporate manager के under आता है. Such a user can perform and view orders and trade related activities for all the dealers under that branch. उस branch के नीचे जितने भी dealers हैं उनके orders और trades perform कर सकता है और view कर सकता है. Then there are dealers. Dealers are users at the lowest level of the hierarchy. हर dealer के अपने clients होते हैं. A dealer can perform view orders and trade related activity only for oneself and does not have access to information on other dealers under the same branch or other branches. There are different corporate manager like clearing member corporate manager, clearing member, trading member corporate manager. Then there is a clearing member and trading member dealer. Then there is trading member corporate manager. What he can do? He can view the outstanding request and activity log for request enter by him. अपनी branch और user ID से देख सकता है वो. This is his default screen. And outstanding request entered by his dealers or any branch manager by either entering the branch and user IDs. Then there are trading member branch members. And finally there is trading member dealer. These are the various kinds of corporate hierarchies available in the F&O segment. Client broker relationship and derivatives. Client broker relationship में क्या क्या चीजें आती हैं derivatives segment? सबसे पहले know your client form बनाना बहुत जरूरी होता है. Know your client form में सारी details होती हैं एक client की, which is very essential for a broker to know. Then execution of client broker agreement. क्लाइंट ब्रोकर का जो एग्रीमेंट है वो प्रॉपरली पढ़ा जाना चाहिए क्लाइंट के थ्रू. एवरी पॉइंट शुड बी प्रॉपरली डिस्कस्ड एंड देयर शुड बी ट्रांसपेरेंसी बिटवीन द एग्रीमेंट. ब्रिंगिंग रिस्क फैक्टर्स टू द नॉलेज ऑफ क्लाइंट बाय गेटिंग एक्नॉलेजमेंट ऑफ क्लाइंट ऑन रिस्क डिस्क्लोजर डॉक्यूमेंट. रिस्क फैक्टर्स लाना क्लाइंट के नॉलेज में. ऐसे नहीं कि रिस्क है तो यू आर मेकिंग द क्लाइंट अनअवेयर ऑफ द रिस्क दैट ही इज फेसिंग. टाइमली एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ ऑर्डर्स एज पर द इंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ क्लाइंट्स in respective client codes. Then there is collection of adequate margin from the clients. Clients are proper margin collect and maintaining separate client bank account for the segregation of client money. Client money ko segregate karne ke liye client bank account banana. Timely issue of contract notes, proper contract notes issue karna. Paying and payout of funds manage karna. Resolving the complaints of clients. Avoiding receipt and payment of cash and deal through only account paychecks. Periodical statement of accounts भेजना clients को. Then charging proper brokerage, ज़्यादा brokerage नहीं charge करना clients ने. And maintaining adequate client code as per the regulations. Client codes maintain करना. There are different type of order types and conditions जो कि अलग अलग type के orders होते हैं जो कि एंटर किए जाते हैं एफ एंड ओ सेगमेंट में. तीन टाइप की बेसिकली कंडीशंस होती है. टाइम कंडीशन होती है. टाइम कंडीशन में दो टाइप के ऑर्डर्स आते हैं. एक आता है डे ऑर्डर. डे ऑर्डर एज द नेम सजेस्ट इज एन ऑर्डर विच इज वैलिड फॉर द डे ऑन विच इट इज एंट. आज 4 जून है. अगर मैंने ऑर्डर 4 जून को डाला है या 3 जून को डाला है, 2 जून को डाला है, तो उसी दिन के लिए वो ऑर्डर वैलिड है. नेक्स्ट डे के लिए वो ऑर्डर वैलिड नहीं है. उसकी वैलिडिटी उस दिन जितने टाइम मार्क टास्क खुले हैं उतने ही टाइम की वैलिडिटी रहेगी. द ऑर्डर इज नॉट एग्जीक्यूटेड दैट डे द सिस्टम कैंसल्स द ऑर्डर ऑटोमेटिकली एट द एंड ऑफ द डे. एंड इमीडिएट और कैंसिल. इमीडिएट और कैंसिल ऑर्डर अलाउज द यूजर टू बाय और सेल अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट as soon as the order is released into the system, failing for which the order is cancelled. As soon as जैसे ही मैंने system में order डाला मतलब वो execute हो जाता है तो well and good, but the order is not further start, the order is cancelled if it does not find a suitable match. फिर price conditions आती है. Price conditions में stop loss orders होते हैं. ये facility allow करती है user को to release an order into the system after the market price of a security reaches or crosses threshold price. Threshold price को cross करने तभी आपको order trigger, that is a stop loss order. This order is added to the regular order log book with the time of triggering as a timestamp or as a limit order also. फिर कुछ और conditions होती है जैसे market price. Market orders कौन से orders हैं? There in which there is no price specified at the time the order is entered, तो वो market में current market price पे ही order आ जाता है. Then there is trigger price. The price at which an order gets triggered from the stop loss.